How do you take an organization that is brilliant, they are world class, they are the best in the history of mankind, and they start seeing the signs that they need to do something different? So in our business of national security, where our job is to fly, fight, and win, our job is to be prepared for the unexpected, our job is to win no matter what, we better be masters at this game of innovation.
It's a complicated problem. It's not just, there's no silver bullet or one thing. It's the relationship of things. And so the strategy is production, but stable production at the numbers that we need over time. That is really the ultimate fix to the pilot crisis.
There are a couple of artificial intelligences that we intend to leverage. One of them is algorithmic in nature, which means that it's a model that's able to instruct students in the absence of a live instructor pilot. This isn't to replace the instructor pilot, but it's to give access to instructor techniques much more on demand for the student.
So look around.
Wow.
And if it's not us, then it'll be somebody else.
In a formal training unit, we are teaching F-16 pilots ultimately to be ready for combat. And so through a lot of the Chief of Staff's efforts have been part of the revitalization of the squadrons is letting all of that decision-making come back down to the squadron. For instance, I can make a syllabus waiver if I think that a student has done well and needs to do one event potentially out of order or to proficiency advance past an event because they've been doing really well. I've got the authority to do that as a squadron commander. And in our discussions of efficiency and in our discussions of trying to produce more students faster, that we don't lose sight of the fact that we still need to produce the same quality of student and make sure that they are very close to being combat mission ready.
I don't have a ton of experienced pilots, which means I don't have a ton of instructor pilots. We're trying to solve a retention problem.
We're just improving force development, talent management. We're taking care of families better. We're treating pilots like professional athletes and working on neck and back care. We're just doing a lot of things that needed to be done to take care of our airmen. And in every crisis, there's an opportunity. So we see an opportunity to really just improve how we take care of our pilots and airmen writ large.
We might have to go out on a limb and try some things that maybe we think they might fail, but let's just try something new in order to potentially get a win in the long run.